Our business model is based on the premise that we will see continued expansion in the global trade of commodities, including oil, minerals and metals. This expanding demand requires a new type of commodity trading company, one which is financially robust, can provide the services required, and also understands the financial risks and challenges that exist in the marketplace. The ability to provide services includes the provision of financing, logistical services, investments and capital to assist companies in both developing new production flows and also in the consuming sector of industries. I would summarise our year as a broadening of our existing activities and deepening of our core businesses. In terms of broadening our activities, that involves expanding our existing business lines. We're increasing our volumes, increasing the number of commodities we trade. We are expanding to new regions. That includes countries such as Papua New Guinea, and while we were present in Brazil previously, we have expanded significantly in there through some investment programs. We support our trading activities through large-scale capital investment in infrastructure primarily, and that has been a major focus of the group over the past year. We have deepened our capacity by becoming more resilient. We've got much better systems. We've developed trading platforms which can cater for the different volatilities that exist in our marketplace. We have got a much stronger balance sheet. We've got longer lines or larger lines with more duration. And finally, we've become very disciplined in the way that we manage our investments in terms of both from an investment point of view and also a divestment point of view. In 2014, we delivered strong results. Our margins increased to 1.6%. And we continue to increase volumes across our entire commodity trading range. Specifically in oil and oil products, we are now trading 2.5 million barrels of oil per day. And we also increased our leading position in gasoline trading, naphtha, distillates, and also in our LNG trading activities. In minerals and metals business, we remain a leading player in the concentrates and refined metals trading business. We also significantly increased our volumes in coal trading, where we've become the third largest coal trader. Trading conditions in 2014 have been challenging. We've seen significant political unrest that has created some uncertainty, and we have seen low market volatility. Our response to these challenges has been the same it has been for the last 20 years. Provide services to the clients, which include capital, logistical services, ensuring we perform, ensuring we have strong platforms and systems so we can help customers manage risk. We've invested in significant numbers of logistical projects. For example, Port of Sodes is where we're combining logistics investment also with trade inflows. It's a port which is located south of Rio de Janeiro, which services the iron ore industry. It's 50 million tonnes capacity, increasing to 100 million tonnes capacity. It'll be starting in January 2015. And it was a joint venture with Mubadala, the Sovereign Wealth Fund of Abu Dhabi. In Colombia, we have the Magdalena River port and barging system, which is providing logistical services to the oil and commodity sector, and also for general infrastructure. In Callao, in Peru, Impala logistics business has completed an investment involving concentrate storage, blending and ship loading facilities. In Spain, our mine in Andalusia has completed a 300 million euro capex expenditure, which will be one of the largest mines in the region, which will be producing copper concentrates, zinc concentrates and lead concentrates. In Africa, we're investing in various infrastructure improvement projects which will support our trading activities in the region. A key highlight of the year was the development of the Corpus Christi asset, which is an oil infrastructure asset, which we subsequently sold 80% to Buckeye, which is an LLP in the US. This investment for us is key because it shows, one, our ability to participate in the shale oil business in the US, and also it demonstrates our discipline in terms of divesting at the right time in the cycle while we've retained trading rights through that asset. We have broken new ground to be the first commodities trading company to join the Extractive Industry Transparency Initiative. to demystify the position that trading companies have when they're dealing with government and other large institutions. It's actually very similar to what we've been doing in the industry throughout the year, taking a leading position in providing white papers, infrastructure, trading, so people understand our business and have a better understanding of what we're about and how we conduct ourselves. The outlook for Trafigura in 2015 is positive. We have a very talented group of individuals within our organisation. We will continue to provide services to our clients, find niches to ensure that we can support them in their business activities. With such a strong platform, we will be able to realise rapid growth without compromising our independence, which is very important to us. Work with local communities to ensure that we have got strong governance and good corporate social responsibility. We aim to continue on our path, that the next decade will be as successful as the past two have been.